the Dark Lord Happy Pants. This is the second part of my Twilight review, and I believe I just finished covering, Bella's stupidity. Now let's cover the fact that she's essentially, what's the right word? Oh yeah, a self-insert Mary Sue. Like, seriously, if you read the description for Bella, Stephanie Meyer's pretty much describing herself. Brown hair, widow's peak, heart-shaped face, pale skin, lips too full for jawline, not at all muscular, and what was the... brown eyes. And pretty much, I think it's funny because, you know, in the beginning of the book, Bella's transferring to a small city, and she's transferring to a school of, like, 300 students, and everyone's so excited to meet her because, like, oh my god, nothing exciting happens in Forks. And we have a new person here. Let's make her one of us. One of us. One of us. Okay, sorry. Couldn't resist. But seriously, everyone's, like, overly excited about her arriving, and, you know, I think it's funny that her school, the high school that she's going to in the book has, like, 300 people in it, whereas the high school and junior high combined that I go to has, like, a little over 100 people total attending. And every time we get a new student, no one really cares. I mean, it's seriously like, oh, hey, there's a new kid. I mean, people do care. It's, like, kind of interesting for a while, but, you know, no one really just gets over-enthusiastic about it. Everyone's just like, oh, okay, cool. Fine. What's for lunch? Are we going across the street today? Ah, math homework. Ah. And then they go about with their daily lives and maybe introduce themselves to the new student and yada yada, so on and so forth. But, let's see. Also, moving on from Bella, let's look at her relationship with Edward. Now, most girls are really crazy about Edward because he's the perfect man. I mean, who wouldn't want a man who's cold, dead, and sparkling? I wouldn't. But, mostly because his personality sucks. I mean, seriously, has anyone else noticed how controlling he is? Like, I believe there was one time when they were in Port Angeles and Bella had just been saved from these gang rapists. Oh, no! But Edward was taking her out to get some food, and she was all, you know, I really don't feel hungry, and he was all, you're gonna eat, and that's final, bitch. Okay, he didn't say it like that, but he was kind of forceful, and really, every time he wants her to do something, she pretty much goes along with it. Yeah. No arguments, really. I mean, sometimes she'll persist and persist and persist until someone else steps in and it's like, hey, Edward, let's go with Bella's plan. I like it. And then he'll be like, okay. But yeah, other than that, he really takes the reins in the relationship. He wears the pants. Okay. Plus, another problem with Edward, he's a stalker. And Stephanie Meyer portrays him as cool. She's all, stalking is cool. You want a boyfriend who stalks you and who watches you while you sleep. That's the kind of boyfriend you want, yeah? Yeah? I don't know why she sends that message to young girls. I really don't. I do not. I think she's screwed up in the head. Yeah. Maybe some psychological trauma in her childhood. I don't know. Okay, anyway. Also, earlier I talked about a character, Alice, and I just want to bring up something that bugs me. Because her fortune-telling abilities are really later explained in the series as being... Ah! No, sorry. Her fortune-telling abilities are determined by the species she was and or is. That didn't make sense. The species she was or is. Like, for example, when she was... She used to be a human so that she could see the futures of humans really well. And she is a vampire, so she can see the futures of vampires really well. But... Yeah, she can't see the future of vampire hybrids or werewolves because she's never been one. Now, if her fortune-telling abilities are based on species, this brings up an interesting question. How could she know what the weather was going to be like? Like, was she a rain cloud in a past life or something? I don't know. But anyway, that's really all I have for today. I mean, I'm going to try to read all of the books in the series again. Sorry. Okay, sorry. Yeah. I'm going to try, and I'm going to try to review each and every one of them. Ow. Ow. Okay, I really shouldn't do that. Enough of my brain cells have died reading this book. But anyway, food for thought time. Are you an anti-Twilight person, or are you a Twilight fan? And if you are a Twilight fan, which team are you on? Edward or Jacob? And, yeah. Oh, and why do you like Twilight, or why do you hate Twilight? Yeah. Tell me everything. Leave it in the comments section. And feel free to subscribe. Yada, yada. Bada bing, bada boom, bada bing, bada boom.